third chapter, 12th through the 17th verse. And we want God to be in the midst. I ask that you be tuned in your spirit that God can have his way. Anybody else with me? Let's go to work. Let us read.
Not as though I already attained.
Come on.
Either were already perfect.
Come on.
But I follow after, if that I may apprehend that for which also I am apprehended of Christ Jesus.
Come on.
Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended.
Come on.
But this one thing I do.
Listen.
Forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before.
Come on.
I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus.
Read.
Let us therefore, as many as be perfect, be thus minded. And if in anything ye be otherwise minded, God shall reveal even unto the, nevertheless, whereto we have already attained, let us walk by the same rule, let us mind the same thing.
Come on.
Brethren, be followers together of me, and mark them which walk so as ye have us for an example.
Dear Heavenly Father, I am grateful for the opportunity to minister to this house. I'm asking that you will rain down such an anointing in this place that will crack the ceiling and break every yoke that it needs to be broken. That every demon, every spirit that is not like you is cast to the pit of hell, never to raise itself up again. I speak now through the power of the blood of Jesus Christ that this authority shall fall upon this place. Now have your way in this place in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Look at your neighbors and take back your press. Take back your press. Take back your press. Amen. Take back your press. Amen. In the British news, I'm finding out, praise God, that Prince Harry and Meghan has decided to step down from senior royalty. They have decided that they are not going to be considered senior royalty anymore. They have figured out that they want to step down. There's been a lot of rumors why they have decided to do this. Some say the pressure of the media. Constantly the media is following them and have been talking negative things about them in the media. Anybody talking to me? There's been consistently hearing negative things about her being of color, of ethnicity or color, and all these other things. But then it was another thing I've heard is that they never have an opportunity to do things without being followed. And wherever they go, there's people outside their houses, amen, paying attention to everything they do. There's just a lot of issues that they said that the media is constantly scrutinizing them, and amen, and the pressure has just gotten so bad that they're wanting to step down, praise God, from who they are. They want to step down from becoming, amen, their titles. And it's amazing on that. But then some say that it's because it's family issues, that the two brothers can't get along and that they're having major problems there. And they just not getting along, and somehow or another the wives are not liking each other, and they really, really tripping on each other in a lot of ways. And so with this being said, praise God, we find that they just want to get out of their positions and not be called who they are. Now somehow they want to give up their status and become regular people. They say they don't want to do the duties, praise God, as royalty family. But can I tell you the truth? No matter what they do, they still are part of the royal family. Can I get an amen? Whether they don't act like royalty, whether they don't walk like royalty, or whether they acknowledge being royalty, they still... Come on, talk to me. It's in their bloodline. There's nothing they can do to actually erase it out of their bloodline. When it's in your bloodline, it's in your bloodline. You are who you are, no matter what people think about you. You still royalty. No matter what they said about your baby, you're still royalty. About your lives, you're still royalty. No matter what you do, it's still in your bloodline. Things I've noticed most of all is that they still want to be respected in life. They still want to be respected. They still want to have the things that they are used to. They are here. They still are living big and riding big and having the nice homes and things, and they still live in the same level of life, but they don't want any of the things that are attached to the requirements to have that. Can I get an amen? They want to be all that it wants to be, but they don't want any of the responsibility that it takes to have such things. I'm talking to somebody, and y'all get there with me in a minute. And it looks like, praise God, they got to a point, praise God, that they just want to have everything, but don't want to be called royal family. I'll give my title up, but I don't want to give my money up. I'll do all this, but I don't want to have the responsibility to go out every week and speak as the prince. I don't want to go out every week and be royal family, but don't take away the things that I've been accustomed to. Don't let me be impoverished, but don't call me by the title. It's amazing, praise God, that you want to stay rich, but don't want the perks and the responsibilities that it takes. I found, praise God, that a lot of us want all the right things, but we want it easy. I'm one of them. I don't want to work, but I still want the paycheck. Let's talk in here together. I want everything that can line up that's going to bless my life and don't want to sweat at all to get it. I'm talking to me. I'm not talking about you all. I'm talking to me. Can I get one other amen in here? We get to a point, praise God, that we all want the easy way out. Oh, help me, somebody. Talk to me, house. Say, yes, he's talking to me. He's talking about me because I'm one of them that don't want to sweat. I don't want anything. I don't want to be sick. I don't want anything. I want everything right just the way I want it, like I want it, and I still want to be anybody with me. I don't want to work at it. I don't want to have to do anything, but I want it just the way. Matter of fact, I want my house clean and don't want to lift a finger. Woo! Anybody with me? I want to go back home, praise God, after church, and I want to have a full course meal and didn't do a thing to get it. Y'all hear me? Just the way I want to cook, just the way I like it. Y'all ain't hearing me. That's the way I want things, and that's the way. Anybody else with me? Matter of fact, I want it so good that when I get ready to leave the house, I want my car started with the right temperature, with the right song playing, and just drive me right to work. Anybody else with me? And when I get to work, if I feel like doing anything, that's the way I want it. That's just it. If I want to go, but if I don't want to go, I still want to get paid. Somebody give God a hand clap of praise if that's the life you want to live. Somebody said, matter of fact, just don't want to work no more. Just give me about $40 million. I'll sit at the crib and do what I want to do when I'm not traveling. Said, holy, let's just erase that job thing. That matter of fact, just let me have it. Am I talking to the house today? This is the way we want it, praise God. But, you know, it's something else about just having responsibilities attached to our desires. It's not easy just thinking that all the time we want things our way. Please look at me because this is the hard part. It takes something to have something. Nothing is free these days. Salvation is free, but to maintain it, you got to do something. Oh, I need some amen in here. You got to understand, praise God, just being saved is just not good enough. It's growing in your relationship is important. Somebody give me amen in here if I'm talking right to you. We want, praise God, everything that's on the plate, but it's going to take something to get it. 1 Peter 2:9 tells us, but you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, his own special people, that you are can proclaim the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Nudge your neighbor, says, hard being special, it's hard. No, that wasn't the one, they ain't catch it. Look at the next neighbor, look at somebody, say, I want to let you know it's hard being special. It's difficult being special. I want to let you know it's not easy being special. Look at somebody and tell them it ain't easy. It ain't easy. It ain't the easiest thing being special. It costs something to be what I am and who I am. And it's not as easy as you may think. I have to work as being y'all not trying to help me out. It takes a little bit. I see anybody else with me. But I want to understand, praise God, but if I want to be all that God has for me to be, I've got to do some hard things to be all that I need to be. Because I read in John 10:10, it said the thief cometh but to steal, kill, and to destroy. And if I know that I am called, praise God, talk to me, saints of God, and I am called, praise God, amen, to be special. If I'm called to be royalty, I just can't give up on my assignment because I want everything easy. Help me, someone. I want to let you know the hardest thing it is just giving up. It's easy to give up, but the hardest thing is to stick in there when things seem to be a little harder than everything. Come on, somebody. Look at somebody. Get my press back. I got to get it back. I got to take back what's been taken from me. Look at somebody. It's time for me to snatch everything the devil ever took from me back. Look at somebody. I need someone in here to grab this, because it's easy to sit on the sideline expecting everything to rain from the opening of the window of heavens and shower down on me. But I understand that for me to have everything God has for me, I've got to do a little more than just stand here and expect it to rain down. Oh, I ain't getting a whole lot of amens. See, some of us are comfortable just where we are. But I come to inform you that if you think you got it going on now, if you just press just a little further, if you just go or tap into this thing a little more, you think you got it going on now, you ain't even touched the surface of what God has for you. That's what that scripture said, eyes have not seen or ears have not heard. That's because he's got more for you than you can ever expect. There is promises lined up with people that press. There are anointing lined up with people that press. There is something lined up to people that say, I am determined. Woo! That neither have. Somebody talk back to me and give God a hand clap of praise. Yeah, it's difficult being special. It's hard because anytime you're special, you got a target on your back. It's not easy, praise God. You got the media, that, you know, those folks that's just hating on you, that's always reporting on you in every way they can. You got them on your back because you're royalty. Y'all not hearing me. I don't matter. Don't hate yourself. Don't trip. Amen. You may not have living in Ivory Hill, but you still royalty. And I promise you, you're going to have someone reporting on you, whether your light's on or off. Y'all not trying to hear me. Whether you're driving or walking, you got some reporters. You got people that's going to report whether your boyfriend cheating on you or your husband slapped you. You got reporters, praise God, that are going to talk about you, whether your children getting A's or whether they getting F's. You got them because, praise God, you are special. If somebody says it's hard being special, and you got to understand that when God called you out and saved you, he sent you into a bloodline that the enemy just can't like. Y'all not trying to help me to preach, but I'm going to preach it and go sit back down whether you like it or not. It's time for you to get your press back, because if you really want what God has for you, you're going to have to do more than what you're doing right now. I'm not saying you're not pushing, but I guarantee you there's more pushing you than right there. Oh, I ain't getting no. See, I'm the only one going to get that. You got more in you, and you got more push in you than what you're giving me right now. And God said if you don't give all that you got, how you expect him to give all he's got for you? Y'all ain't trying to help me out. Some of us want the easy way out, but this time and fashion that the enemy is saying, not so. God is saying to me to tell you that you got to get your press back. Somebody give God a hand clap of praise. Woo! Oh my God. Amen, amen. We know that the devil come to steal, kill, and destroy. It's a promise that it says in his word. He's gone to steal, kill, and destroy. He comes to take from us. He comes to try to get us. He wants, amen, everything. But listen to this. But sometimes when he comes against us, we begin to want to lay down. We begin to want to get lazy. We want still the same. We want the same love of God, but we don't want to press to do anything. We want the same level of salvation, but we don't want to study. No word. Oh, I ain't getting it. I know this was going to slow you down, huh? We want the same level of protection, but we want to do and go anywhere. Huh? Oh, y'all not trying to hear me. We want to know God as we always have, but we expect God to come and show up. But we ain't talked to him in a whole month. Ain't spent no time in our private closet. Ain't spent no time on our knees. But the minute something go crazy, here we go on a tap on the door of the kingdom of heaven and expecting to rain down, but we ain't pressed for nothing. We ain't put our plate down for nobody because God has given us enough to eat every day. So some of us even skip the idea to even pray while we eat. We'll say thank you, Lord, while we're sticking it in our mouths because we're so busy and blessed that we've gotten to the point that we don't have to press for anything. And the devil is using the blessings of God to keep us from going any further. Oh, I don't get no whole lot of amens in here. But God sent me by here today to tell you that it's time to get your press back. And if you think you got it going on now, I'm going to say it one more time. There's greater deeps and higher depths. There's more blessings. There's more favor. There's more anointing. If you think you living good now, when you start doing what God say for you to do, he will open up the windows of heaven and pour all upon you blessings that you won't even have room to store. Your next door neighbor will start being blessed. Your children across the country will start being blessed. You'll be able to speak stuff into the atmosphere and it'll shift by the, oh, y'all ain't trying to hear me. Oh, my God, I got to preach it anyhow. See, we want to feel the same presence. We want to come in here and feel the Hashanah the Boshata on us, but we ain't spent no time. We want Brother Jeremy hit the right key and make us shout around this church, but we ain't spent no time. We expected everybody to do everything, but we ain't spent no time. We got to learn to press. Oh, God. It's easy to find fault when you ain't spent no time. It's easy to find excuses when you ain't spent no time. It's easy to judge when you ain't spent no time. It's easy to look at everybody else when you ain't spent no time. When you ain't pressing, it's easy to find a way out. Oh, you want to find your flesh the way out. But when you're pressed, you can't get enough of God. When you're pressed, you don't want nothing else but God. When you're pressed, you know the goodness of the Lord. When you're pressed, you begin to go shout. Oh, God, help me, Lord, to preach this thing. We've gotten to this point, praise God, that as the Bible say, that if he don't shorten the days, no flesh will be saved. We've gotten to a point, praise God, we want it every way our way. We want it when we want it, and we can justify what we don't. But the Bible has not changed. It has not twisted one word. And because we live under grace and mercy, and no, God has not rained down and killed none of us and sucked us up with fire, and have not allowed the enemy to destroy us, we think we're doing all right. But I just want to encourage you, praise God, that God is looking for greater. God wants to do more for you than you ever had in your life. God wants to bless us to a level, praise God, that when he comes back, he can look at and say, well done, thou good and faithful servant. He wants you to, amen, whatever you have, whatever gift you got, he wants you to operate in it, stir it up, and use it for his kingdom. Because when you put everything you got in God, God's going to put everything he has for you in you. Oh, I don't need a whole lot of amen. See, that's when you forget you and get God. God got a chance to do you. Oh, y'all ain't catch that. See, the more you think about God, the more God rain down and take care of you. I need an amen in here. Son, you need to. Praise God. Amen. You got to praise God, get to a point, amen, that we got to, amen, be able to know that God is number one. I don't need no whole lot of amens in here on this one, because we got to realize, praise God, that when we start doing this thing, God's got a chance to come into our lives and tap in. See, reason whether you know it or not, God's probably been knocking on some doors, but because you've allowed so much else to have his way, that you can't let God in as well. See, y'all miss some things. Let me tell you something. Sometimes you can miss your blessing because you're so busy about you that your blessing is shot right by you. Sometimes we've been so busy about what we wanted, and God's wanted to bless us into ways, but because we haven't pressed, because we, oh, Because we haven't pushed, because we haven't been faithful, God can't rain down. We begin to think about the emotional things because the enemy has came against us and trying to take our royalty away. He's come against us to try to stop us from being the princes and kings and queens God has called us to be. He began to attack us and we begin to be like the royal family in Britain, say, I'm tired of it. But the minute you say, no weapon formed against me, oh, y'all ain't trying to help me out. Come on, I'm over here, I ain't over there. Come on, son. Somebody. And then once you begin to realize that that's all the devil is trying to do is steal your priesthood from you, trying to make you think that that's all you got to do. But the minute you stop being you and stop being what God, oh, oh God, oh, oh, shut him on my shot. Oh. Once you start being him, once you start being what God say, once you stop looking at yourself and what you desire, once you say, God, I'm pressing from this day forward, I'm going to start lining up with your word. I don't care how hard it is, no matter what it looks like. I'm just going to do what your Bible say do. And I'm expecting results of your Bible say. No matter how it look, I'm going to do it. No matter what nobody else said, I'm going to do it. No matter how many devils come against me, I'm still going to do it. No matter how many people talk against me, I'm going to do it. No matter how many days I got to fight, I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it no matter what it take. I'm going to press because I want to be blessed. Give God praise in this place. It's going to take that. It's going to take that. It's going to take some days when nobody else is going to encourage you. See, I know that sometimes we need encouragement. But when you got a good relationship, you can just encourage yourself. Praise God. Sometimes you just got to wrap yourself up and roll yourself around and hold on to God. You got to be, praise God, say, I'm going to hold on to until you bless my soul. I'm not going to let anybody doubt my word. Praise God. I'm going to live this thing. Y'all not hearing me? That's the kind of thing God wants us to do. That's the kind of way we're supposed to live. And we, praise God, are losing our press. That's the nation. We're losing it for all sorts of reasons. We're accepting a lot of things that God is very not pleased with. Just as a nation overall. Who would have ever thought that we have a president that cheated on three wives and lied about everything he say? Who would ever thought we got a man by the name of Buttigieg that's got a husband? People are voting to become the next president of the United States. Now, everybody's got a soul, but who would ever thought? We're losing too much, praise God, and God is looking for people that really want this thing right. Can I help some of you out? Some of you haven't read Revelation, but that's going to be a time that he said two going to be together. And you're going to think you're ready. One going to be called up, and the other one going to be left. And it don't mean that you hadn't been a churchgoer. It may have been that you haven't gave God all you had. There's a parable God, Jesus said, it said that he said it was a rich man that was leaving home and he had his talents he was giving out to him. That was money back then. And he gave one five because I know that he would do what he had to do with the five. And he had the abilities to operate with five. So he gave him five to operate with when he left. Then he gave one two because he knew that that man could do good with the two. But then he had a servant that he gave one. He said, I know that he'll work with this one and do well. But most of us know the story, but we miss to understand one thing. Is that the one with the five doubled it. The one with two doubled it. But the one with one did nothing. How many of you got one and doing nothing? How many of you are not pressing and doing all you know how? That when he come back, he can just say, you've done well with what I gave you. Stop looking at people with 10. Stop looking at people with 5. But work with what you got. Now, I don't know what's going to happen with Megan and her husband. And I don't know how that's going to turn out, but they fed up. But God sent me by here to tell you today that you don't give up no matter what it looks like. One thing about it, once you start losing the press and start losing your motivation, sometimes it's hard to get it back. Once you start it, it's hard to shake yourself back in place. I don't need no whole lot of amens, it's the truth. Hard to get back to reading your word and fasting. It's hard to get back to praying and seeking God because you've gotten comfortable right where you are. But I want more. Not just because God can give me more, because I know I deserve more by the word of God. So what I'm preaching today is about where is your press? So I love what Paul said. He said, listen, first of all, I want to let you know I ain't got it all together myself. The first thing he said, I ain't accounting to have it all. But he said, I'm going to do one thing. I'm going to forget everything that's behind me. All the stuff I've dealt with, even my errors, even when I didn't do well, even whatever was causing me not. But he said, what I'm going to do is press towards what is my blessing. And that's what God wants us to do today. People are going to say, oh, because you're changing, now you all that. You tell them, I ain't got it all together, but I got to leave what you're doing. I'm finished. I've given you word of God just as raw as I can give it. Now, I'm going to start. There's some spiritual trash cans at the back door now. You can't see them, but they're there. They're on both sides of those two pillars at the door. And I'd ask that if you're not going to use these words, throw them in that garbage can so I can recycle them and give them to somebody else. It's going to stay back there from now on. They're spiritual garbage cans. So if you don't want this word, give it. I'll just go back there, get it, and hopefully somebody else will take it. But don't leave here with good word and don't operate in it. They're going to be back there from now on. But if you take the word out of the house, begin to look at it. I know I flash. Come on, anybody, I'm wrapped up in this stuff. This stuff is something else. It cuckoo for Cocoa Puff. Anybody else got cuckoo for Cocoa Puff? That stuff will mess you up. Oh, I'm the only one. That thing will mess you up even in your dreams. I woke up the other night, I said, oh no, I drunk some oil behind that one. Ain't nobody else. I got drunk it. I said, Lord, this is it. I just couldn't ignore it. My head had to drink the oil. It was so vivid. And the devil wanted me to go right back to sleep in that dream. I said, oh, no. Because it's real. Come on. So don't think it's not. Don't be. It's okay to have. No, you got a war. But get your press back. Everybody standing. You know, I'm not trying to close our services shorter. I'm not trying that. I'm not trying to do anything but what God is saying. But it's important that we do when the word comes, because I got a lot more notes up there. But I need you right now to really evaluate yourself. Every head bowed. We are going into our 19th year of ministry. 19 years. And it's been a blessing to my life. And I've been the most gracious and so blessed man I could ever be. I look around and see that God has just favored me. And I realize I owe him everything I ever own and anything I ever be. And every platform or every stage he puts me on or everything he allowed me to do, I owe him everything. And I realize, praise God, that it's easy to get weary in well-doing. Somebody talk back to me. It's easy to get tired with all the things of life. Come on, anybody else with me? Anybody else got life that just seems to be so much? Every head bowed, every eye closed. From day to day, you got so much going. It seems like you're overwhelmed with the thoughts and trying to keep it all together. You're exhausted. Amen. Some of you haven't caught up with your sleep in 2 months, no less than a week. Some of us got so much impact in our spirit, praise God, we don't know how to let it be released. And amen. So it's hard, praise God, to press when you just oppressed. Oh my God, am I talking to anybody? That's things that we went to God for and hasn't been fixed. And things came on top of that, and then things came on top of that, and then life come on top of that. Anybody else am I talking to? But God sent me back here to tell you, if you seek me, praise God, with all your heart. He said, I'll start doing things and taking care of things and moving things. Now, how do I know this? Because he has done it for me. Oh, oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Come on, come on, talk to him, come on. Oh, thank you, Lord. I just want to thank you, Lord. Yes, yes, thank you, Lord. Come on. Whoa, whoa, thank you, Lord. You so worthy. Thank you, Lord. Now listen, with every eye closed and every eye, every mind on the Lord, talk to him right now. Say, Lord, wherever I'm short, wherever I've allowed myself to fall, or wherever I allow things to enter in, wherever I felt like giving up, wherever, God, the enemy has attacked, or wherever life has came in a place, where I've stopped doing what I know to do, God. Wherever I've just taken you for granted in areas where I know I can do better in. Wherever I've allowed things to have more importance than you, God. Wherever I've found myself, God, not doing what I need to do and I know I should be doing it. And God, I justify not doing it. Come on, someone. Whatever I is, God, right now, God, I want you to help me in it. Come on. I want you to bless me, and I want you to strengthen me. I want you to give me a new hunger, a new blessing, a new favor. Come on, anybody with me? I want you to touch me in that area, God, because your mercy has been there for me, God. I know you blessed me, God. I know you've kept me because, God, I can see it throughout my whole life. And so right now, God, just forgive me. Touch me, strengthen me, move upon me, come on, favor me, come on. Oh, thank you, Lord.
So many ways you
come on.
Whoa.
Come on.
So good.
Come on, son.
Whoa.
Come on, somebody. Lose it. Come on.
So good.
Come on. Go past that.
You've been so good to me. So many doors you've opened. So many ways you've made.
Come on.
So many times you've healed me. You've been better than good to me. So many doors you've opened. So many ways you've made. So many times you've healed me. You've been better than good.
Better than good to me.
You've been better than good to me.
Better than good to me.
You've been better than good to me.
Better than good to me.
You've been better than good to me.
Better than good to me. Talk to him.
So good.
Talk to him, saints.
You've been.
Talk to him.
So good.
Whoa.
You've been.
Talk to him.
So good. You've been.
Come on.
So good.
Whoa.
So good. So many doors you've opened. So many ways you've made. So many times you've healed me. You've been better than good to me. So many doors you've opened. So many ways you've made. Oh, so many times you've healed me. You've been better than good to 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 me.
Lift those hands and let's leave. Heavenly Father, I surrender myself unto you in a different way. If I haven't been pressing, God, if I lost my press in any way, I repent of my ways right now. I ask that you will favor me from this day forward, God, that my will be totally in your perfect. Now bless me, God. Help me not to justify me, but help me to seek you as ever before. Renew the right spirit. Help me never to let down again. Help me to seek your favor and your desired will for my life. In the precious name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen. Now listen, we're finished. Now I ask you right now, keep playing, we're getting ready to leave. This is it. Listen, everybody in here last week, that preacher asked us to do an hour's worth of prayer. That's a real good start. God has given us to be 100%. He's given us every do the right thing. He's just given us anointed message after anointed message this year. So I'm encouraging you, praise God, this week to find yourself still in the way, getting up early, whatever it takes to find that time to pray. If you haven't learned to pray, just lay there and just don't get up. Set an alarm clock, whatever it takes. Learn to get that hour in. Then find yourself meditating on a scripture. If you don't know how to do that, just get the daily breads. We put them in both foyers. Start there, but it's very short reading, but meditate on a word every day. That's your beginning of your press. Then we'll go further in our fasting again. We'll corporately fast. We'll get back to that together. Amen. Grab someone's hand. Grab someone's hands. Praise God. Amen. Heavenly Father, I'm grateful. I'm grateful for this day. I'm grateful for your mercy. I'm grateful for second and third chances. Now, Lord, in the name of Jesus, as we prepare to leave this place, none of your presence. Be with us, God. Help us be according to your will. Help us to operate according to your way. We say yes to your will and your way today, God. Move upon everything about us, God. Oh, my God, in the name of Jesus. Bless, Lord. Touch, God. In the name of Jesus, we do pray. Thank you, Lord. Amen and amen. Give God a hand clap of praise. Turn to your neighbor. Tell him you love him. You are dismissed.